the concept of the Citizens Government Academy was to provide the group with 9 weeks of interactive sessions with different county leaders.
We are the best county in the entire state. And why? Simply because of you.
Being able to meet some of the members of the government of the county, it just really piqued my interest in terms of how the government of the county works with the government of the city of Conyers.
I am very excited about the Citizens Academy.
And give them an inside look of county government.
I think it's a great opportunity for members of the community to see what's going on at every level.
The Citizens Academy is a phenomenal opportunity for our citizens to take an insider's look at the functioning of our government.
Over the past 9 weeks, they've visited the Fire Training Center.
That's up to you. Captain LaBelle has the fire going, so whoever wants to come up first.
So that's for the power
for this. Yeah.
Okay, got it.
They've been to multiple different facilities.
Just about every county in North Carolina through that's their home state has one of these. What you're looking at is essentially a mobile animal shelter. We can actually scan the animal and figure out, is it lost, who the owner is, contact them.
They toured the water treatment plant.
Once we cleaned the filter, we had that chemical right there.
They've heard from every county office.
You all should also have a copy of the actual script.
They've been to the courthouse.
Is there an initiative in place in this court?
We have the CHINS program, and
I just think it's a great program to learn about the community, and you'll come out feeling so much more empowered just about where you live and how great of a county Rockdale is.
The participants got a tour of Johnson Park.
We do offer baby showers and small parties in this house.
They also visited J.P. Carr.
It's going to be very up close and very intimately personal with all of the directors, able to ask them questions.
For the last 9 weeks, each class had a different menu, and we tried to serve some variety and also cater to those that had different food preferences or allergies. So we've tried to make it well-rounded, and we took feedback from each session so that next year we can even provide better food.
I've paid my bills as long as I've lived here, so why hasn't everybody been held accountable?
They had a tour of the senior center.
Sign language practice.
I had a real interest in terms of how the government works.
So this concept of equity is really what's fair.
Our judges have councils, and those councils have staff that review everything.
I've just looked at different ways that I could network with people and partner with them in order for us to get things done in our subdivision.
Every aspect of real estate is right here, stored in here, right here in the real estate department.
This, for example, tonight was all about learning about the clerk's office and also the different courts.
The students for this session were chosen out of an applicant pool to participate.
The information came across my email, and it was just a link, so I clicked on it, and I really was very interested and gave me an opportunity to really learn more and do more.
And that's why I took this class. It's because I say somebody's got to get a hold of this.
Have a stormwater subcommittee.
How many more people do you need to put in shovel-ready positions?
Well, I thought it would be very interesting to find out additional details regarding all the different departments that are funded by our taxpayer dollars.
There was an application process. They had to answer why they wanted to be included, what other kind of organizations they participated in, and basically show interest in learning about county government. During the 9 weeks, the citizens were actually, each session was designed so that there was a question and answer period at the end, or actually a lot of them they could ask right throughout the presentations.
It was new, it was something different. Since then, becoming the HOA president in my subdivision, it began to be something that was very important to me because I needed to connect with county officials in order to be able to service our community.
I thought the questions tonight were very insightful, very engaged, and I think they're going to be very great ambassadors and in terms of debunking myths from reality for their fellow citizens and neighbors.
Also, they're getting a tour of the courthouse. I think it's really important to understand a lot of people don't go to the court until they absolutely have to. So if you haven't had the opportunity to come to the court and see everything that's going on and, you know, all the needs that we have for our growing community, I would encourage you to do that.
Is there any kind of technology that's going to be linked in to help people when the water, you know, when they get a leak or a runny toilet?
Absolutely, but it does come at a cost.
We had a great time tonight at Citizens Academy discussing the EMA division or department. I told them about the three divisions, 911, Animal Services, and EMA that make up the EMA department.
They could do things online. They could actually fill out applications with a Dropbox.
Every time I leave a session, I come away with something else that I didn't know. How the intricate pieces of the department really works to service the neighborhood, you know, or my neighborhood, and also how it services me as a homeowner.
Other than right here within the courts. So here we are, we're in the civil department.
I know that the court system holds a lot of mystery, a lot of intrigue for many people because their knowledge base pretty much evolves from court TV shows, which in many cases are just the opposite of what real life courts and judges, how we function.
As opposed to bring that child into the actual court system.
Just because you don't have to have a lawyer represent you or your business in magistrate court doesn't mean it's a good idea always.
I appreciated that they were so responsive, and I just wanted to know more.
I've taken 7 pages of notes already. In 30 sessions.
But in terms of dispatch, do you respond from the closest fire station?
So we have what we call first due. That's that first arriving unit.
This was a great opportunity to reacclimate, to learn how our local government works here. Like I said, that's my background, and so I totally like this kind of stuff.
Tonight for the citizens government graduation, we're going to have the participants will get certificates and a gift. All three commissioners will be present along with many of the county leaders and managers that they met throughout the 9 weeks to celebrate in the culmination of the program.
This was the very first inaugural 2021 graduation of our Citizen Government Academy.
Graduation night is exciting. And I actually got a little nervous and I was like, my gracious, you've graduated a few times. What are you getting? But it's important. It's valuable.
Judith Barnes.
I think what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to put it in my den. I have a lot of important certificates hanging in my den, so I'll add this to it.
Michelle Ford.
Going to take my certificate and put it in my office. I am very proud of my certificate. I dressed up for graduation tonight.
Judith Orchard. Tia Johnson. Tia Johnson. George Kelichick. Leslie Lambert. Kashia Marshall. John Allen. John Penn. Christine Peters. Tommy Plummer. John Speck.
Congratulations to the 2021
Citizen Academy graduates. It's so good to see so many people take an active interest in learning more about local government.
That's a huge, huge commitment, and we really appreciate that.
It was just exciting to see how many people participated. The fact that they had to come every week for 9 weeks, and they did. They had assignments, they worked at it, and they really did accomplish a lot.
A big shout out to those people who have really helped bring all of this together.
And I'm excited to see the dream turn into a reality.
We had good food, good music.
Chicken, and I had some salmon, and I had some awesome potatoes, gravy and everything. Awesome.
I am a more informed citizen, so now instead of complaining about things, I know how to take action and do something about it. I know who to reach out to.
9 weeks of classes and then one night of graduation, and we hope that that doesn't end their journey for this group or for any future, that this isn't the end.
This really just broadens my scope of knowledge regarding the county.
I've enjoyed the whole 9 weeks. I never missed a night.
The Citizens Government Academy, we're looking for more people to sign up and get ready for the 2022 class.
My husband is now interested in doing the course in the fall because I talked about it so much every time I came home.
I've already emailed 35 people to come to the future sessions. Yes, sir.
We have not set the dates yet as far as the application timeline for next year, but it will be posted on social media, on the website, and we'll do a PR campaign at the board meetings with all the specific deadlines. So it will have another class in the fall of next year, 2022.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Again, we really appreciate the citizens, and that's what we're here for. We're here to answer questions, and we welcome that.
So give them all a round of applause. Yes.